Hi, I'm Andrew Strome, and today I'm going to walk you through a core set of hand tools for the beginning woodworker. It's a very focused set, but it's also tremendously versatile. There's a lot that you can accomplish with it right off the bat, but it's expandable as your skills develop and your interests change over the years, and as your budget permits. So these tools are intended to supplement any household tools that you might already have. What's important to remember about them is that it's not necessarily the specific brand or model of tool that we're recommending, but more the capability that each of them provides you. So for measuring tools, you're going to need a tri-square or a combination square. Favor a combination square simply because it has a longer blade than a tri-square does, and it's also adjustable so that you can use this to gauge from the end here to the fence. You can use this to gauge a specific distance. It also has a 45 degree angle face on the head. Marking gauge is a simple but ancient tool. It consists of a stock with a movable fence and a pin. And what it does is it marks a line parallel to an end or an edge, and it's essential for laying out joinery, whether it's scribing the depth of a rabbet or dado joint or the baseline of a dovetail. This is an older traditional wooden gauge. Modern gauges are also made. You can see the architecture is the same with a stem and a fence. And instead of a point, this particular gauge has a knife cutter for incising a sharp line, particularly in cross grain work. So a marking knife incises a fine, precise line that you can work right up to with your chisel or saw. So a back saw is specifically designed for cutting joinery. This spine stiffens the thin material of the saw plate so that you can make precise cuts. This is a carcass saw. You could include a tenon saw in your kit if that's what you happen to have. The other tool that you're going to need is a hand plane. This is a jack plane. It's simply a blade held in this metal body at a fixed angle. Planes are used for taking shavings off the surface of wood, so you can use them for smoothing edges, for planing surfaces for their finished appearance so that you don't have to resort to sandpaper, and also for trimming joints flush. You'll need a wooden mallet. Wood is the preferred material so that it doesn't damage the handles of your chisels. I recommend two sizes of chisels, a wider one for removing large amounts of material. This one's 1 inch, 1¼ inch would be fine as well. And then a narrower chisel in the 1/2 to 5/8 inch range. So these are the woodworking specific tools that you'll need to get started. You probably also have some tools around the house. Tape measure, some screwdrivers, various sizes of twist drill bit plus a drill, a small claw hammer, a rule, and a crosscut handsaw. So in following videos, I'm going to go through each of the tools in more detail. If you're just starting out in woodworking, this is an excellent and versatile set to begin with. Thanks very much for joining us, and we'll see you next time.